prove that stealth had the capability to reintroduce surprise in aerial warfare.
We tend to be a very, very confident group. We know our risks. You just know what you have to do, and you're able to concentrate and do whatever it takes.
We don't fly this airplane during the daytime. It's going to be flown at night, and you've got to get comfortable with the night, or else you're going to become a statistic.
be the first chase on that airplane. And we took off. We kind of did joking around. I'd end up on the moon. And we were like,
we'll be right back.
picked my pilots for Just Cause, and Major Greg Feast was my number one choice because he was my best shooter. In the aftermath, he had to sit there and read all that press about how he couldn't hit anything with a $46.2 million airplane. You know, he erred here, he made this mistake, he made that mistake. And throughout all that period where you know he was taking all that press and rolling around in his mind, he was still my number one shooter. And on the 15th of January, when I made my final cut on who was going to be the first 117 guy to drop a bomb, there was
which is 3 o'clock in the morning Baghdad time. And we had a saying at that time that the quickest way home was through Baghdad. And we knew that once we started it, that it'd be over fairly shortly, we hoped.
At 11 p.m. on January 16th, the first wave of stealth fighters left for Iraq. The Allied command staff had pinned their hopes on the 117. They sent the plane to destroy Iraq's heavily fortified air defense system. If stealth worked, it would open up the sky for thousands of Allied planes. If it failed, this would be a long, brutal war. At 2:51 a.m., Greg Feast dropped the first bomb of Operation Desert Storm